Hello everyone, here we're going to look at using Pytest and fixtures. In order to use fixtures, you need some functions to test. So what I've done here is some functions which extract the email addresses from some JSON. And if you look at the top here, URL equals HTTPS JSON placeholder to be code.com. If we visit that URL, you can see if I zoom in, we've got post ID, ID, name, email, body. So now, if I couldn't view it by clicking the link, I could actually just inspect it by doing a GET request and then passing the individual dictionaries within the list. So you've got one dictionary there, another dictionary there. Each time there's a comma, that means there's another item in the list. So it's a list of dictionaries. We can see that. Now, that's available at JSON placeholder. Pytest, so we're going to be using fixtures. And the reason we're going to be using fixtures is because they can save some repetition and it is good practice, particularly when you're working with databases. So what I've got here is response equals requests.get URL. Typically, you would use that if you were doing a minor web scraping project, maybe using Beautiful Soup or just making a GET request to any old API. Res underscore JSON is actually the response as JSON. The reason we need that is because we're going to work on it and we are going to pick out. So we're basically encoding it back to its format. It gets serialized when it gets transmitted and then it gets encoded back to JSON, Python dictionary format to work with. So I've got a function here, find code.uk email. Then we're just going to go through each row in the input file and we are going to identify where the email address is equal to code.uk. And the other one, it'll do the same, but it's going to find where the email address is a .NET. And just down here, I've run the function here. So if I run it from here, run Python file, and you can see if I make that a little bit larger, you can see it's gone off. And because I ran just the find code.uk email, in main, it's gone off and found all of the code.uk addresses from that big file which we made the request to. So, if you're not familiar with VS Code, what I want to just quickly show you is how you can just run this from the command line. And if you experience troubles running Pytest using Pytest, calling it that way, you can actually just specify your Python version. So Python 3.8 is what I'm using for this. Hyphen M to import the modules and then Pytest. And I am in the top diction, the top directory of my project. So if we run that, I've got two passed tests. Now, I haven't shown you how to write the tests yet, so let's do that. And what we want to do is go into the test directory, which typically you will make when you create your project. You'll make some, like a cookie cutter you could get, which would set this up for you. Either way, you can just make a test directory, tests. And inside that test directory, you also want to create a dunder init dunder.py file. It helps Pytest find the files it needs to test. And here we go. So if I open that to the side, move that across. I find to explain this, it's better to keep the original code on the screen as well. So hopefully you can kind of see the test which we've got here. So import Pytest. The reason I need to use import Pytest, you don't always have to do that if you're just writing a basic tests file with Python. But if you're using fixtures, you need to do import Pytest. So import requests, because we're going to be using requests to create our fixture. A fixture is basically a way to get or set up some things which you will need to pass into one or more of your functions within your tests. So this fixture is called get underscore JSON, and you can see I'm using it here in this test with the green tick. And I'm using it here. If I had four tests that were finding code.uk, .net, .com, and so on, then I would be able to reuse this one fixture in four places. All I've done here is pretty much replicate what I've done in my main code. So response equals requests.get and then return response.json. That response.json is then what gets passed into test underscore find.co.uk function. And same for the email, the .NET email. What I've done here, result equals find.co.uk co underscore UK underscore email, which I've had to import. So this is one of the common things you'll do with PyTest is your reference from P1. So P1 is actually the name of my code that I'm writing. And then you import each function. So from P1, which is the code on the left, my main project, import findco.uk email, find.net email. So the important line to remember really from this video, if you don't remember anything else, is at pytest.fixture. And the scope is optional, so you don't actually have to have that. So let's just, for simplicity, just remove that. This gets the JSON and then makes it available as a fixture. So the at is the decorator. So that enables you just to use get underscore JSON. You don't need the parentheses after the JSON word there. And the assertion, which you have in every PyTest, or you should do, is asserting that .co.uk is in the first result returned here once, and the result is basically find underscore co.uk, which is this function here, which was the whole purpose of my project. So as you've already seen, the find underscore co.uk email returns a list of .co.uk email addresses. Now the other thing I can do here is if I also bring up the activity bar, view, appearance, activity bar, and then if I run the test tube, you'll see run the tests and they should all pass. So remember, you need to set up the fixture with at pytest.fixture, empty parentheses, or you can specify the scope. I'm not going to cover the scope here. There's more advanced videos than this which will cover that. But really, just remember at pytest.fixture, it basically sets up everything you need for each of your PyTest tests. Now, why is this so important? It's important because when you're writing a test, the test should be independent. The success of each test should be independent of any other test. So this is a fixture. It's not another test as such. If you'd written this badly, you could end up trying to pass the result of your first function as a parameter to your second, which, although you may do that with your normal code, it's bad practice to do it with tests because tests can be called individually. Now, if we come back across here, I'm just going to show you what it looked like again here. And two passed in 0.48 seconds. If we just do, I'll just clear this and I'll just show you the tree structure. The tree structure of this project as well, because I always find that useful. I wish more people would do that. And then you can see I've got a test directory, which we saw in VS Code. The test that we've just seen is test underscore find underscore email.py. And the bonus thing I just want to show you, which you may or may not have seen before, chances are you haven't, because I hadn't up until recently, but this is a really, really useful command, and it's Python space dash I, let me just specify 3.8 while I'm at it, dash I, and then the name of my file. Because I'm in the top of my directory, I can just call my program, so p1.py. So it runs, and if you remember in main, I had find co.uk email. So it's calling this function here. And it's returning a list of co.uk email addresses from that big load of JSON, which, if you remember at the start of the video, Each of these has a dot something or other email address. .biz, .com, .tv, .biz, .com, and so on. So I've written a function to find the co.uk email addresses. So coming back here, now I've run it with the dash I, it hasn't quit. So available to me now, I have, if we do dir, I've got all of these functions which I can, functions and variables which I can call. So if I wanted to inspect what find underscore net underscore email is, you can see that's a function. If I want to check what the URL was, we can see it there. If I want to check what the response looked like, response 200. If I want to see what ls underscore net looked like, it's empty because we didn't call it from main. But if we want to see what lscode.uk looks like, we see it's got all of these values in it because it was called from main. Now, this is a really handy way to debug or to save having to debug, because if you just run Python-i, then your project, your project runs, but then you can still go in and inspect the variables. So that's really handy sometimes. Remember that sometimes you'll be trying to look at an object which is just a function, other times you'll be looking at a variable. So for instance, URL was the variable, so that's why it showed us something semi-useful. But then if we just look for a function which is just an object as well, not so useful. But then if you actually run it with the parentheses, maybe more useful. So that is a really good tip, which I wish I'd known ages ago. It just saves effort when debugging. You don't have to rely, for instance, you can do this from the command line much easier. You don't have to rely on using something like VS Code or what are the others, PyCharm, and so on and so on. So one last thing, always remember the init file and put tests. So test underscore, and then it's good practice to, I have not done it here, but it's good practice to call your function the same as the function in your main file, but just prepend it with test underscore. There is another way of doing it. You can actually specify the function name followed with underscore test. There's different arguments for and against each of those, so just choose one and stick with it. So hopefully this has been interesting, and I will be back with something else in the future. Thumbs up, subscribe. So few people subscribe to these videos, which actually doesn't really encourage me to make many, so that's why they are not very frequent now. So please, please, please subscribe, thumbs up, leave a comment, because the algorithms seem to be quite fussy and they just put your videos in the bin if you don't get thumbs up, comments and likes. So please, please, please subscribe and all that. Thank you very much. Bye.